Sir, in fact, for the benefit of the students, we have been receiving not only from the point of view of the executive company law paper, though the webinar is specifically targeting on executive company law paper, for the benefit of the students who will be watching this webinar, we are covering the other queries also. So, as far as corporate restructuring and insolvency paper, whether the Companies Act 1956 is applicable or Companies Act 2013 is applicable. In fact, we have been receiving queries from, in fact, practically on daily basis this query. We are again reiterating that as far as corporate restructuring and insolvency paper, the major portion is relating to amalgamation, merger, winding up, etc. So those chapters are based on the Companies Act 1956 only, because it's still under Company Law Board is functional and it is under 56 Act. But the provisions relating to buyback of shares is already notified as far as financial restructuring is concerned. So the students can read the provisions relating to buyback of shares from the supplement provided by to them, and in addition they may refer to the amendment made in SEBI rules for listed company as far as buyback of shares are concerned. So the 80% of the study of corporate restructuring and insolvency is based on 1956 Act, except for section 61 relating to alteration of share capital and buyback of shares. And one more query. The sections which are not notified under 2013 Act, will it be included in December 2014 exams?
No.
It will not be included. Another question, what are the important sections in company law 2013? As such, 283 sections are notified, and majorly it is based on the functioning of the company. 282 plus, actually 282 section plus section 1 was notified on the day 1 itself, and it covers all the procedural aspects, conducting of board meeting, conducting of general meeting, functioning of the board, disclosures, filing of forms, everything. So it is very difficult to segregate which is important section, what is important to be read.
Important section means important section from the point of view of the examination. But the only thing I would like to tell you that, shall I say the moderator?
No.
So I would like to tell you that you go through the study material. If you want to clear your paper, you go through the study material first. Because if you see the trend during the last 2-3 examination, most of the questions have been set from the study material itself. Don't go for any book which are available in the market in as such, and don't go, because these sort of queries have been raised earlier also by students. So that's why I'm suggesting you go through the study material. Each chapter is important for you. If you find that that particular chapter is, you'll have to go through the 2013 Act, you'll have to amend your studies in that manner. And rest of the study material, of course, 1956.
In fact, your functioning as company secretary will happen in toto.
Toto.
When you work as a company secretary, you will not see whether I'll read this section, everything will be applicable.
All are important.
So we advise that you read the entire study material. And one question is relating to pattern of question paper. The pattern prescribed under for the old syllabus students will have old syllabus pattern. The pattern prescribed under the new syllabus students will continue under the new syllabus. Sir, one more question. Will the examiners will be keen in on mentioning the sections, number and rule while writing the answers?
No, generally what happens, section as such may not be, of course, must be sure that that whatever section you are mentioning is perfectly correct. Then only mention. Don't don't mention where you have got any doubt about the section number. And what I will suggest that you, it's not necessary that you have to reproduce the entire the language of the section. You write in your own way, but whatever you write, that should be complete in our respect. Then only it gives sense.
Sir, what does substantive law means? One student is asking.
Substantive law is that which is, you see, that is, I have already mentioned, substantive law is the legal portion, on the basis, original idea, original concept, and which requires the assent of the parliament, and finally by the president has to give his assent, only that then only it can come into force. That is the substantive law. And that procedural aspect is that to implement that substantive law, how the how you have to act, in what manner you can put into force in that particular section. That's why procedural aspects have been introduced. And then in that procedural aspect, of course, because that doesn't require the approval of the parliament in that way, because every change in the modification, amendment of the substantive law require that Parliament's consent, Parliament's has to pass that particular bill. But in that procedural aspect, that is not required. That has to be placed before the Parliament. If Parliament has got anything to say in that matter, to that extent it is modified and then it comes into force.
Sir, one question is, when in the case of voluntary conversion of OPC to private company, which form is to be filed? Actually, INC 6. They have to file INC 6. Sir, there are questions about the subsidiaries and the layers of subsidiary and the intent of the sections. Can you, because there are not more than two layers of subsidiary.
Now there shall not be more than two layers of subsidiaries, and you'll have to take care of those things. Because earlier subsidiary to subsidiary and subsidiary, because ultimately you do not reach anywhere. That's the main problem. So that way it has been tried to avoid. Because it's the new act, and you cannot have more than two layers. That way. And that has been made very clear in the act itself.
So the student is asking, the Companies Act is talking about vigil mechanism. Can you just tell me about the vigil mechanism and what is the intent?
Okay, we'll look into that. Vigil mechanism.
Sir, in fact, whistleblower mechanism that has been made mandatory. In fact, clause 49 also.
Clause 49 is specific.
It has been made mandatory. In fact, section 178 of Companies Act talks about vigil mechanisms. 178. Basically, it is whistleblower mechanism, whichever is
actually from
when there is a mismanagement or when the affairs of the company is not conducted in a proper manner, then the person can blow the whistle. For that, the company has to have a mechanism in place so that the affairs of the companies are conducted in a proper manner. Sir, there is a query. suppose it's regarding MGT 14, special resolution. Suppose some sections are not notified, then I pass the special resolution under the 1956 Act. So, what is the procedure that I have to follow? That is the query, sir.
So, in those cases, I think new form relating to those sections. Sections will not be
applicable. They have to continue with the old procedures. As we talked about the conversion of public to private company, there is a role of National Company Law Tribunal. Since the procedures relating to the under prescribed under Companies Act ought to be followed. Similarly, for the special resolution passed under the 1956 Act, where the provisions of 13 Act is not notified, the procedural aspects relating to those aspects will be under 1956 Act.